We'll get going then. Good afternoon, everybody. I just have a statement here to read with some information, and then we'll go around. If anybody has any questions, we'll try and answer all your questions. So, as of today, anyway, the latest projections from the National Weather Service have the river reaching a level at or near 23 and a half feet early Friday, April 28th of 2023. Additionally, we have information we may have a crest as high as 25.2 between April 28th to May 1st. This would be just shy of the record 25.4 that we had back in 1965. Crawford County Emergency Management and City Administration are attending daily webinars with the National Weather Service to monitor this situation. Both agencies are working with other communities affected in Crawford County. The shelter facility will be the Hoffman Hall Recreational Center for those who wish to use it if they experience flood water in their residence and need to evacuate. For all those requesting the evacuation site, contact Crawford County Emergency Management at 608-326-0266. In the event a resident decides to evacuate, please contact Madison Gas and Electric at 1-800-245-1125 and Alliant Energy at 1-800-255-4268. We have received bottled water for all those who need some that are affected by the flood. The water will be available at Hoffman Hall Recreation Center and also at the Tourist Information Center. As the river continues to rise, we encourage pedestrians and bicycles to not travel on St. Phil Island. On Monday, April 24th, Prairie du Chien High School students will be volunteering to assist any residents needing help. Due to a higher predicted river stage, the wastewater treatment department is asking that all people that are or will be receiving flood water into their basement that they place a plastic bag and a couple sandbags over their floor drain to prevent floodwaters from entering into the sanitary sewer line. A slow no wake will be in effect as well in all flooded navigable waters in the city of Prairie du Chien. Sandbag operations. Bags have been filled and delivered to the location at the corner of East Washington Street and North Ohio Street over by the Prairie du Chien Street Department. Those who need sandbags and have no reasonable means of picking them up should contact the PDC Chamber of Commerce at 608-326-8555. In the event of an emergency, obviously, you call 911. Municipalities and townships who need sandbags should contact their chief elected officials. The city and county are looking for volunteers who would be willing to place sandbags around the city and Crawford County. Please call 326-0266 if you would like to volunteer. Some people I'd like to thank for their efforts, Prairie Sand and Gravel, Patterson Sand, and Kroll Ready Mix, which have all donated sand to fill sandbags. And also I'd like to thank the prison down there that they are the ones filling the sandbags. As far as entering restricted areas, the following rules apply in both City of Prairie du Chien and throughout Crawford County. Number one, you can receive permits at no cost at Prairie du Chien City Hall between 8 and 4:30 p.m. All permits will be approved prior to issuance. Permits are required for any business located or operating in the restricted area. Upon entering any restricted area, you must call Crawford County Dispatch Center at 608-326-8414, state your name, contact number in case of emergency, the length of time and purpose for being in the restricted area. And upon leaving, you should notify dispatch center that you are now leaving the restricted area. Each time a person enters and leaves the restricted area, they are responsible for moving the barricades that are blocking the road. For example, you arrive, move the barricade, drive through, then immediately get out of your vehicle and replace the barricade behind you. Repeat the process when exiting as well. If there is a business surrounded by floodwaters, the permits do not allow for pedestrian or vehicular traffic through the floodwaters. Access by boat is permissible at your own discretion, but law enforcement fire personnel will not transport you by boat. Please keep in mind the slow no wake is in effect for all waters under the jurisdiction of the City of Prairie du Chien. Violations of these rules could result in penalties or revocation of further access to restricted areas. And I've already covered some of the sandbagging operations. I'll give you the street closures as of today. We have North Main Street is closed from Frederick Street to the north down to West Court Street, and Washington Street from North Beaumont to North Main Street. First Street from West Wells Street to West Brunson Street, and of course all of St. Carol Island is basically underwater, so obviously that's closed. So if anybody has any questions, if I can't answer it, we have Mr. Hackett here, our emergency government coordinator, and we have Larry Gates, we have Chad here. So anybody have any questions? You first.
Yeah. So yes, you're on my list to call back today.
Don't even bother calling. I just had to come. I know you're swamped. I know that.
So yes, the plan is that we'll have those high school volunteers. You're on the list that we're going to have. That we'll get the high school volunteers, along with the city has graciously offered to get some trucks and things like that there. So that will be included with the sandbag operation that the high school is volunteering, along with fire department volunteers. Did you leave a voicemail today saying that you had somewhere for it to go? Yep. So wherever you have to go with it, we can take it. Yep. Yep, we just talked about that at our last meeting. With the city, and the city said that they would find some cement blocks for that, and firefighters would help lift and put it in there. 20 people, you think?
20 blocks.
20 blocks?
Because I've got refrigerator stove, washer dryer, refrigerator.
So any of those unmet needs, make sure that, for yours I have covered. I have yours wrote down on the list. Okay. But any other public that has those unmet needs, call that Chamber of Commerce number, and then that's where we'll be organizing all of this response that the city is.
Was taken off. So rough on an 80-year-old lady. I am probably going to buzz out here.
And I just want to put that out to the community as well. If you leave a message, we will get back to you. It has been an extremely long wait of time. We're getting through the messages we can as our preparation, and that is one of the reasons we activated the Chamber of Commerce to answer some of those phone calls, so you'll get a person and you can talk to someone. Through the weekend, it will not be staffed. It'll be an answering machine, but Bob Moses with the Chamber of Commerce will be checking on it throughout the weekend, in the afternoon and at evening, and we will be able to organize, and anything that it would be a necessity right then might not be able to wait till Monday, and we can work through it. Yep. So you are on our list to bring over. We graciously, from the Prairie du Chien High School, got 50 volunteers, or around 50 volunteers is what they're estimating, to come over and help us. So we will gather the list for the community, and that doesn't only include the city of Prairie du Chien. That is the whole Crawford County that needs volunteers. We'll put them on there, and we'll work through until everything is done. And that includes all the way up to DeSoto. I mean, it's been a group effort all the way through. And we're gracious enough that the city works with the county and all the townships and villages. Like, we're all one big partnership.
Monday
morning, we'll be gathering all the information. You'll hear from me within Monday early afternoon, before noon, because then the high school is coming over right at lunchtime, and then right at lunchtime, so the kids will be fed, they'll be getting on buses and coming wherever we need them. So we could probably do the cinder blocks earlier with the fire department. I will organize with them to see if we can get that done earlier.
It won't be long. I won't be in and out of my home.
Thank you for understanding.
Make sure you stop and put your quarter in, though, at the Eagles club.
I'm going to do it.
All right.
Perfect. I'm in jail. So if I need a ride, can I call you?
Yes, you can.
It could happen.
Yep.
I'm going to be pooped out when I go up there.
I bet.
Give me a drink.
All right.
Jed, we talk.
The lady there in the pink, you had your hand that raised. You had a question?
No,
I mean...
That's really just the St. Phil Island is really the restricted area. If you have a residence, if you have a house and you get to get to it, you're absolutely...
Yeah, you're no problem. You can get to it. We're not going to stop you from...
And I'll add to that, in no time have we said we are going to make any evacuations mandatory. It is at-will evacuations. If you feel like you are in danger from the floodwaters or anything that is going on, we have that set up with Hoffman Hall. But we are not going to force anyone out of their residence.
The main thing is to keep the gawkers from driving down by your house through the floodwater. Because if you move a barricade, and it doesn't get moved back, it's like cows in a pasture. The cars all head to it. So you just got to make sure the barricade gets moved back. We saw that firsthand the other
last
day.
Last night, yeah. Or the night before. Yeah. Lady in the back, did you have your hand up? Okay. Yep. All right. The latest projections are reaching a level at or near 23.5 feet by Friday, April 28th. And it could go as high as 25.2 between April 28th and May 1st. And that would be just shy of the 25.38 flood record, all-time record that was in 1965. Anybody else have any questions? Yep, back in the back there. Sandbags? I would think you could, if nothing else, at least put some sandbags to try and hold it back a little bit. Well, we have sandbags available for you.
Dave, I can help on
that. Yeah, I want to go ahead.
The sub pump will take off some of the pressure that would be coming behind. So yes, it will help. No, by no means is sandbagging a guarantee it's going to save life or property. It is a chance to stop it. So while you're doing your best efforts, yes, I would recommend if you're that close, it's probably time to sandbag instead of wait. And so at 22, it wasn't there yet?
No, it wasn't. About 4 feet from the door.
Just to give you a thought of where your timing is, on Monday, you're still going to be fine at that 22 is the projection. So then it won't be in your house yet. So if you need the help, we will have those high school kids available too.
It could get that high. They can't say 100% for sure yet. As of now, they're actually talking 23.5. But...
And some of these volunteers can help get it up to your main level. But if you needed a place for it to go, that's where you'd be looking at finding a storage unit or something like that. The city of Prairie du Chien, I know we didn't talk about this in here, but did say that if you are able to get, what are the pods? That they would allow the parking lot of what used to be Blackhawk Junction for storage of pods at your own liability.
As far as getting the pods, you mean?
Yeah. So yeah. If you call that Chamber of Commerce number to get on that list, Monday we're going to organize all of the response to come out with those volunteers. Yes, call. So that way. What was that? Well, I would call to just in preparation. If you're planning for. My recommendation to everyone is to plan for the worst, hope for the best, is what I always say. And with these projections, and they're coming out every day at 1 o'clock, and we're having meetings every morning, we'll have the most up-to-date information. But with it looking at cresting at between 24 to 25.2, and yesterday's crest said just a little bit higher than that, where they're still thinking up in that 24 to 25.2. So that's what I would plan for. Now, I know that that's a ways out because that was up till May 1st's projection. So kind of play it by ear, but I would recommend while you got the help, use it instead of when it's too late. I'm not familiar with your house. I'd have to see. But where you're looking at, Larry, I know you got your projections, but what's...
430 South Main.
Now I know where she's talking.
Yeah. But that heel.
Right. Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
So they're talking about those sub pumps, that any of the seepage that's coming from the groundwater on the other side of the bags, that's what you're throwing out on the other side.
Yeah,
I think that would be a good response. Like I said, anything is just preparedness. I can't promise that it would save it, but I think it's a good plan.
All right.
Go ahead. So we meet with the community leaders every morning at 9:30 in the morning. At 1:30 is when the weather service sends that out to community leaders, and then I just shotgun it out to them, and the news releases. Watch your news releases, watch your Facebook media pages, because they'll put it together and put it out to the best projections in the news releases. So I see you back there. I'll get you in just a second. Most of our news releases have been running through either as a co-op between Chad Abrams sending them out, or Mark Myrie, who works under me in emergency management. Chad will send it to him, and he'll make sure to get it out. If anyone's not on those email lists, please reach out to Mark Myrie at the Crawford County Sheriff's Office Emergency Management to get added. We're using the same list that we use for all of our sheriff office news releases combined with our COVID-19 news release. We combine both of those together, and that's how it's getting out to the media. But it will be updated on our Facebook pages as well. We have the Crawford County Emergency Management page that we've been putting it on, and watch the City of Prairie du Chien's Facebook page because they've been pretty diligent with their news releases.
Go ahead,
Melissa. I will include it from now, and I think
we, from now going forward.
That
today,
not trying to scare you, but just so everybody's got the latest up to date.
Right.
The most accurate estimate they have is those hydrologic charts. When you go to River Stage at McGregor, that's the best estimate they have at this time. That's why they only go out the 7 days. Once you go out of the 7 days, it's less accurate. But that's still their projection. To the 7 day mark, yes. The future projections are not on those pages just because of the reduced accuracy.
Yep. It was shut down that one summer because they had a lot of scouring going along the bank there. But yeah, as of now, we have not heard anything from them.
I want to put it out again, just so everyone knows, if you do not get someone at those numbers, someone will get back to you. Realize that we have an abundance of calls coming through, and we're prioritizing as we can through. It doesn't mean that what you are experiencing is not important. We understand, and we're working to get to you.
Go ahead, Melissa.
They can call that 608-326-0266. That's my office line. You may not get somebody, leave a message. I've started a list, and then I call everyone back to let them know I've got their information. Volunteers have it added to the list, and they're my last to call back because I'm prioritizing. So it may be a day before you hear from me because we're getting through all these other priority calls.
Yes. If we can wrap it up then. Thanks everybody for coming. We'll try and keep you as informed up to the date or up to the minute as we possibly can. When we know it, we'll get it out as quick as we can by whatever means possible. Probably social media is the quickest way, I think, Jim, isn't it?
Yes.
And we'll get it out there. Try and keep you up to date as much as we can. Thank you all for coming.